What is going on, everybody? This is Game with Red, and I got a new game, The Park, that just came out, and I'm going to do a walkthrough on this, and I figured why not do a commentary. So, ready? 3, 2, 1, let's get right into it. I've never played this before. It's supposed to be a scary game. Let's check it out. The Park is a narrative experience best played in a dark room wearing headphones. It deals with subject matter that may be disturbing to some players. During the course of the play, the park may manipulate graphics, audio, control settings, and your sanity. This is a perfectly normal and... Oh, I wasn't fast enough. Hopefully you guys read that. The Park. Loading time's a little rough. I will give them that. Hopefully this is a decent game. It's only supposed to be like an hour to 2 hours, according to the description. And takes place in an abandoned amusement park, so. I figured, let's see what this is all about. Why not? Funcom presents.
In my heart and mind, I always return to Atlantic Island Park.
Where's Mr. Bear?
I haven't seen Mr. Bear, Callum. Stay in the car. I'll go and ask information.
Okay, looks like we have control. That camera moves real fast. Got a run button. Park goes. I know I'm supposed to go that way, but I just want to kind of check over here. Wow, that camera moves quickly. Right, see if there's a setting for it. There's really no run button. It's kind of weak. Look at that popping. This is running on the Unreal 4 too, which is kind of interesting. I'm just kind of checking it all out. I know I'm supposed to go that way. I'm kind of a bad parent to leave my kid in the car. Really wish there was a run button. Nothing's working, so apparently there's no running. I'm gonna take my sweet ass time and good lord. Hopefully they give you a run, because if I gotta walk around the whole game like this. Check out my kid, I guess. Can't jump, can't run. Atlantic Island Park, bingo.
Attention, patrons. The park is now closed.
They let me go out this side. Can I leave? Bye, kid. Leaving you here. He's on down the road. Little whiz reference. How far are they going to let me walk away from this place? Ooh, what is that, something creepier? This is literally, it feels like I'm walking, like I'm stuck in molasses or something. There's no running. Something creepy looks like it's up here. I don't know. I'm going to check this out. Ooh, something's going on.
I have things I need to do in the park.
Oh! Achievement. Oh, 100 points. Holy shit. The mist. Leave the park. Did not even know that was an achievement. Haven't even looked at the list. There you go, guys. First achievement. That's quite interesting. No.
What am I thinking? I can't leave.
Well, how the hell do I get back now? Uh-oh. Did this thing glitch on me? This may have glitched, guys. Okay, there we go. Jesus. You can kind of... That's cool. You can actually see yourself. I really wish... Hold on. I gotta change some settings here. I apologize. Let's go down to 3 on that. Yeah. There's no controller options, huh? I guess we just walk super slow. God. This is not cool at all. Oh, we got our first achievement. That's kind of cool. Alright, let's see. There's a lot of popping in this. We're on the ride still. Atlantic Island Park. Seriously. This is gonna drive me nuts if this is how slow she walks the entire game. Okay, let's check out this plaque.
Callum was born the day this place opened. This is his favorite place in the world.
Atlantic Island Park. A tribute to the untamed heart of the Solomon Island and the people who has used their talents to bring dream to Nathaniel Winter to life. May this park be a place where joy and laughter are gathered and used to infect all those who follow after. Dedicated this day of May, this first day of May, 1977. James B. Lindsay, okay. Let's go see what's up with this scoot. Go talk to him.
What?
Okay.
Hey, Lorraine. Lorraine.
Don't this dude knows my name? Lorraine.
People lose things all the time. Take a deep breath. Think about the last...
Lose things? My kid's in the car.
Hey, stop.
Oh, shit.
I think your boy just ran into the park. I'll unlock the gates for you.
Oh, no. I guess that's the premise. We lost our son?
Callum, I told you to wait in the car.
This way, Mommy.
Oh, achievement number 2. Welcome to the park.
Wait for Mommy, Callum.
Come on, this way.
Atlantic Island Park. Nathaniel Winter. That's a creepy looking dude. I'm not gonna lie.
Wait for Mommy, Callum.
Over here.
Oh my god.
There's something special about the entrance to an amusement park. A line drawn between the real world and the world of whimsy within. On this side, the apathy of our everyday lives. And on the other, anything we might dare to dream. It's no wonder Callum ran back inside. I wouldn't want to leave either.
Attention employees, the park is now closed.
I'm just going to throw this out there. This is slow as dirt. I can't walk up it. I'm stuck with it. And I'm not sure. Oh, there we go. Oh, transformed to night. I don't like this. I don't like this at all.
Oh, park.
Did I get... Ooh, I can run.
What happened here?
Okay, good. We got running at least. Let's see.
It's easy to get lost here. Stop, Callum!
Let's go check this place out. Look around here. Jesus Christ. Ugh, just scared me. Stupid birds. Got my headphones cranked up, so... Every little detail. Alright, which way should we go? Tunnel Hotel. Doesn't look like it's that big of a place. Now why don't we go this way? This thing looks quite interesting. Wish I had a flashlight or something. What the hell is this thing? Okay. Gary Killiam is Satan's whore. Okay. What do you say, guys? Should we go in? Let's check over here first. Ah, screw it. Let's go in. Check it out. Can we go in?
Too dark. I'm not going in there without a flashlight.
Ah, so I do get a flashlight somewhere. Okay. Let's go this way. Something's gonna jump. I guess this game's got a lot of jump scares, so I'm preparing myself mentally. The shades are drawn. It's nice and dark in the room.
Wait for Mommy!
Okay.
I think this belongs to Callum.
The hell is this thing?
Chad the Chipmunk, huh? Just a drunk guy in a suit.
Chad the Chipmunk welcomes you to the Atlantic Island Park. Chad can be seen in daily ice sculpting shows in the following locations. 11 a.m. Sideshow Alley, 1 p.m. the Octotron, and 3 p.m. the park entrance. Chad the Chipmunk, worst in class. Chad can't even seem to pass. Chad gets angry, likes to fight. Chad is beaten every night. Chad will have a dead-end job. Chad will die a useless slob. It's kind of creepy. Yeah, I'm going to check out the restroom. Can I go in here? No. Definitely. Ooh, what do we got here? Handwritten note.
What's this?
No, I want to read it. Purchase the land on Solomon Island for a pittance. I might add, whatever an Archie Henderson did to the locals, just the mention of his name had people slamming doors and locking shutters from the moment I arrived on the island. My lawyers had arranged everything in advance, but the realtor still had to come and deliver the keys to me personally. He took it upon himself to offer me another warning. I don't know what you're planning to do with the land, Mr. Winter, but the soil here is bitter and cursed, and the curse carried from an old country. Old man Henderson, he did terrible, dark things, the land remembers, sir. I dismissed him shortly afterwards, mostly amused by his pathetic attempts of warning me off. I have a great vision for this place, and the will to see that the vision through to the very end. Atlantic Island Park, name... The name is perfect, and I cannot imagine it being anything else. This is the start of something amazing. Okay, so it sounds like we bought this land even though we were warned to stay off it because there was a curse. Or whoever it is, not us, but whoever bought it. Alright. I have a bad feeling about this. Ugh, creepy laughs. I thought those were people. Alright, well. Can we actually go down onto this thing?
Callum, stay where you are! Where are you?
Can we go on this thing?
Where'd you go?
Oh, I guess we can go on it. Okay. Well, here we go. There goes nothing. This isn't creepy or anything, just riding ourselves in the middle of the night. Oh boy. This is not normally my... I kind of like these kind of games. I know a lot of people are going to be like, oh, it's so short, why would you buy it? I kind of like these little adventure type games.
Near a great forest, there lived a poor woodcutter, his wife and his two children. A boy named Hansel and a girl named Gretel. They were very poor and had very little to bite or sup. What will become of us? The woodcutter asked his wife one night. I tell you what, husband, we will take the children into the thickest part of the forest tomorrow and abandon them there.
How was that?
No, my wife, I cannot do that, said the man. Then we will all four starve, you fool. Hansel and Gretel
overheard
their parents talking, and Gretel began
to... controller just shook.
Do not fret, Gretel, Hansel said. He crept out of the
what
hut
the hell is
and gathered
what is that?
Stones from the ground.
You guys see that over there? What is that? What is that?
The next
is that
morning,
the mascot? The
woodcutter leads the children into the
forest. Oh shit, don't jump
before
in here.
Before they leave, their mother gives them a slice of bread and warns them that they will get...
Oh, look at his eyes. Oh, son of a bitch. Oh, no, no, no.
Hansel leaves a trail
of sweet. 100 point achievement, Chad.
Into the woods.
Had a conversation. Oh my god. I don't want to look at him anymore.
Follow the trail back to their parents' house.
Nope. He's not there. Okay, he's gone. Whew.
After receiving a thorough scolding from their parents for getting lost in the woods, the children are sent to bed without any supper. Hansel tried to sneak out and collect more white stones, but found that the door was locked. Tomorrow I will take them into the woods myself, the wife told the woodcutter. In the morning, their mother gave them a slice of bread and led them deep into the forest once again.
Creepy. Oh.
Hansel
this is
broke
creepy.
His bread into pieces and left a trail of breadcrumbs to lead them safely home.
The sound design is incredible.
Bird snatched up the breadcrumbs and his trail was destroyed. Abandoned by their parents and unable to find the trail home, the children wandered in the forest for 3 days. The children stumbled into a clearing with an exceedingly strange house. Its walls were made of gingerbread, and its windows were panes of clear sugar. Hansel, desperately hungry, ran forward and began to nibble on the walls. Nibble, nibble, little mouse. At my house. An old woman emerged from the house, sniffing the air and peering around with cloudy eyes. Oh, you dear children, who brought you here? Just come in and stay with me. No harm will come to you. But Hansel and Gretel stayed back, for the old woman reminded them of their cruel mother. Come, children, don't be afraid. I have something for you. The old woman offered them 2 enormous lollipops. The children took them and began to eat. You see, nothing to fear here. Come inside, the old woman urged, and the children, still licking their sweets, followed.
Oh, Jesus.
Once inside the house, the old woman changed.
There's something about the atmosphere.
She stuffed Hansel into a cage.
It's perfectly done here.
And put Gretel to work, sweeping and cleaning her hut. Your brother will make a good mouthful, the old witch told Gretel. Once he is fattened up, I shall feast upon him. Time passed, and poor Hansel refused to eat, fearing the day that the witch would eat him. The witch, for her part, grew impatient. Today, I will cook and eat your brother, Gretel. Climb inside and light the oven. But Gretel pretended not to understand. I do not know how. Where is the opening? Fool, the old witch said. The opening is here. And she moved to show Gretel. Seizing her courage, brave Gretel gave the witch a shove, and the old crone tumbled forward into the oven. Gretel slid a large iron bolt over the door to the oven. Gretel freed her brother Hansel, and together they lit a fire beneath the oven. And though she screamed and begged, the children sat by the oven until her screams had stilled, and the witch was cooked. And then, because even children can't survive on sweets, they divided up the body of the old witch and ate her.
Ugh. Oh my god. I have to say, this is very well done. Oh, jeez. Literally just made my skin crawl. That's awesome. That's so awesome. So awesome. Wow. I have no idea how much content's in this, but that alone is pretty cool.
Callum, where are you?
Oh, got an achievement. Swans, gingerbread, and chocolate. Take a ride through the Tunnel of Tales. Well, it's definitely not stingy with achievements.
Hansel and Gretel. I used to read it to Callum when the electricity was shut off. Those poor children. The whole world against them. The forest. The birds. The old witch. Even their own parents. I used to imagine that Callum and I were the kids in that story. Not mother and son, but brother and sister, hand in hand against the unkind world.
It's a little weird.
We were always hungry, looking for our own house made of candy, looking for the sweetness that could take the pain away. Hunger leads people to desperate, terrible places where the tree branches reach like claws.
Kind of reminds me of a mix of We're All Going to the Rapture and The Vanishing of Ethan. I really want a flashlight. I will say that the sound is amazing.
Another accident. This place.
Okay, something's going on here. What am I? Make sure I don't miss something. Can I open the van? Oh, shit. Jesus Christ. Desperate for the constant interruptions to work, Atlantic Island Park will be open on time. The governor is booked to cut the ribbon, so the only real question is whether he will have any customers. I'm not truly worried. The customers will come out of simple curiosity. I deduced what was needed from the canned writings of Archie Henderson. It's astonishing to think that the resonance of positive emotion can be used to fuel such a process. Henderson himself chose to use negative, and that caused some of the taint that still emerges in this, or still lingers in this place. I will not make his mistakes. Very soon I will know if it has been for nothing. Look at that teddy bear. Got a knife in his eye. I want to go look at him a little better. Look at that thing. Is there a flashlight on the ground or anything? Can we do anything else here? Nothing else around here? It's an interesting note. I really wish I had my flashlight at this point. Alright, let's see. Very cool. And the wind has done well. The hell was that? You hear that? It's like a radio or like a... I'm not sure what that is. It's creepy though. Oh, look at this thing. Noise sounds like it's coming from over here. Before I go over to that ride, I'm just gonna make sure this I didn't miss anything here. I think we're supposed to go over on that ride. Let's kinda look at it. Look at this. It's kinda crazy. Alright, well, I guess I'll swallow my pride and hope that there's no jump scare. Actually, I kind of want one. Hasn't been totally scary yet, but scary enough where, or not so much scary as,
this old thing used to make the blood run to my head. It'd make me dizzy.
Make sure we're not missing any kind of notes or anything. I should probably look on both benches here. Can we use these? No. Oh, see?
I remember this.
Me and Callum. Oh, check it out. Hell yeah. Family ties. Nice.
Treachery, you know what? Thoughts. Treachery that lashes like a whip and scars our insides. First time I saw Callum, my thoughts betrayed me. I looked down at this wrinkled, red, bawling thing and I thought, is that it? We build our world from expectations, and the world that I had built for Callum is no different. He was so real, so there, and so far from my expectations. And they shattered, and as they fell in pieces, that one treacherous thought became a new foundation. All of the love that we shared, all of the warmth and goodness that followed, built on a single, traitorous thought.
Okay, let's try decreasing the speed now that we're done talking. I don't know if it's gonna make a difference.
I can't get on while it's moving.
Okay. So I guess we gotta just bring it to a stop completely. There we go. Keep doing it till it stops. All right, guys. Let's see what happens. Let's go try it. Oh God, I have a bad feeling. I have a really bad feeling. Why does the moon look like it's a Batman symbol being projected? Oh God. I will give it credit. It feels like I'm at Six Flags or Disneyland, even though it's kind of creepy. I'd love to go to a haunted park like this. Oh shit, what's going on? Whoa, what the hell was that? Whoa! Holy shit. No. Have no interest. Oh. The hair on my neck is standing up. It's quite interesting. Quite interesting indeed. Wow. I don't know if you're experiencing this at home or, you know, wherever you are watching this, but just that just made the hair on my neck stand. Okay, we can go down that bridge, which is not the way we came in. Let's go this way a little bit. Make sure we're not missing anything again. This isn't the way we came in. Oh, here we go. Read page. I wish I could zoom in on these. Frustrated by the fact that the plan seemed incomplete. I knew as well as anybody that the rules of the game can't be changed with enough money. Or can be changed with enough money. But no matter how much money talks, it can't conjure up missing plans from thin air. I've tried contacting the organization who sold me these plans, and they are stonewalling me. Every contact that I had, every meeting place that I have watched, are swept bare. I have a sinking feeling that I have been swindled. We've gone ahead with what we could find in the plans regardless. This harvesting machine is the transplant mechanism, etc. I'll probably let Nicholas name them something cute for the day we open the park. They will be rides after all. Okay. I guess we're gonna go this. I really could use a flashlight. It would be nice. I mean, it's not that dark, so I'm not super worried about it. Okay. Alright, here, hold on. Let's see. We got a map. Let's see what else we got going on. Octatron, Ferris wheel, bumper cars, House of Horror. Will they let me go in here? Probably not without a flashlight, right? Can I get in here? Swear to God, something better not look back at me. I did see some kind of spark. Oh, there's sparks inside. Alright, let's see if there's any jump scares. No. Alright. Well, let's continue on, shall we? I mean, I've done two rides and it looks like there's only six, I think. Flashlight. Music's building up a little bit. What do we get down here? Okay. What do we got? Take
constant crashes in 80s music. I guess it floats someone's boat.
Bumper cars? Shall we go check out the bumper cars? Examine device. What is this? Oh, cool, cutscene. Pretty awful. Oh shit. Yes. There we go. Nice. I haven't even looked at the list of this, so. Maybe I'll get 1,000, maybe I won't. I like to take my time in these kind of games, kind of go through and check everything out. Especially if the game's only supposed to be an hour to 2 hours, depending on what you do. What we got going on in here? Anything? A flashlight. Can we ride these things? Might not be able to ride these. If not, I'm going to look at every one of them to make sure I'm not missing some note or a collectible. Kind of hoping we get to play it with the 80s rock and roll. Oh, there's some stairs over there. Can we get out to those stairs? I can't jump. Wait a minute. Can we get out there? Guess we can't. Oh well, I tried. It looked cool. Looked like we should be able to go there. Let's keep checking around and see what happens here. Not sure what that noise is. Wait a minute, there's only one with lights on. I didn't notice that before. Oh god, alright. Let's slowly check it out. Oh, I knew it. See? There's always something like this. Accident report. Employee name, Francis. Oh! And we get an achievement. The shakes. Take a ride on bumper cars. Okay. Even though we didn't ride. Alright. It's Francis Dufresne. Date of accident. The 86th of October, 1976. Laborer working on the crane. Brief description of the accident. During the transport of the bumper cars into the arena, one of the straps attaching the load of the truck came unlinked, causing a cascade of bumper cars onto Francis, who was attending, who was standing directing the driver. Francis was crushed by the weight of the cars, describing the injury. Francis was killed. Did the injured employer see a doctor? Yes. If yes, did they file a workman's petition? Workman's comp form, yes. He filed for workman's comp. He's dead. Maybe his family gets it. I don't know. Okay. So, supervisor comments. Dexter, the truck driver, claimed to have seen someone on the back of the load undoing the straps. Nobody reported seeing that. The sheriff has requested that Dexter provide them with a urine sample. They think he's on drugs because something happened. That's interesting. What could have been done to prevent this accident? Double checking the straps after transit should be mandatory, and drug screening for all drivers. Okay. Whoa, whoa, whoa. No, 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 no. Oh shit. Oh. Can we go this way? I don't want to go that way. No, no, no. No, I want to go this way. Oh, we have to go that way, son of a bitch. Alright, you guys with me? Let's go. It's not scary in the way that, you know, like, oh my god, like, I'm a big sissy here. It's scary in a good way. It's fun. Like, your heart's in your chest kind of fun. Like, what the hell's gonna happen? The lighting, the texture, the sound is amazing. Like, the hairs are on the back, like, standing on the back of my neck right now.
It's a matter of public record that I am a failure as a mother. Once, when Callum was very small, I left him asleep in the car while I ran an errand. Don't even remember what it was. When I came back, the sheriff was standing next to the car, watching my boy through the window. I didn't like what I saw in his eyes. Judgment. He wrote me the ticket without saying a word. Just the scratch of his pen on the notepad. When he gave it to me, our eyes met. I know what you're going through. My daughter, Helen, she... just gets some help. Help was a bolt of lightning.
That is generous.
Help was 1,000 volts surging through my veins. Help is agony. I'd rather die. I wanted to scream. I'd rather you pulled your gun and shot me. But instead, my mouth said, yes, Sheriff.
Oh, boy. Check this house because I think I have to. Is that something? We got a. Here we go. We got a page. Continually delayed by the incompetence of the builders. The problem is that they are locals and they believe a lot of the rumors about the old man Henderson used to do here. They grew up on those tales. Every time a bolt comes loose or a wrench goes missing, these fools are cressing themselves against the black magic. Of course, that is why I chose this site over all other potentials. Solomon Island is the nexus for dark energies, and the thought of all that power just dissipating beneath the earth here, it makes my skin crawl. I called in a few favors back in Brooklyn to get someone to the local academy to see if there is any interesting books about local history. Turns out they do, and it seems to be old man Henderson has some pretty strong connections to the Brooklyn crowd. Perhaps something went wrong and it helped me find a piece of the plans that I am missing. Is that a flashlight right there? Nope. It's like gas though. Oh, what the? Oh, the shadow. Jesus. Ugh. Scaring myself here. Alright. We're gonna have to go on this thing. Probably could skip it, but I kinda wanna go on it now. Alright. Make sure there's nothing around. Alright, what do we got going on here? Alright, let's slow this thing down. There should just be a stop button on this thing. Alright, this is probably gonna be scary, but let's go and take a ride on the damn thing. Here we go, riding the Ferris wheel. I mean, if I was looking for my kid, I don't think I'd get on a ride just because. But, you know, you never know. Where's the old man? He's gonna pop up somewhere, I know it.
People come into your life for a reason. Dad used to say that before Mom ran off. After that, he mostly just drank. Things were different for Don and I. When we met, I was sweeping the floor at Susie's diner. He came in with some workers, but he didn't try to flirt or cop a feel like the others. He just ordered a coffee and sat there, watching me. When my shift was over, he offered to walk me home. I don't know how to describe that walk. We talked and laughed and eventually kissed. It felt like love. It felt like a fairy tale. I can't tell you if Callum was made that night or one of the ones that followed. But I think it has to be that night. That one perfect night. Don and I moved in together, but then, well, he died. According to the supervisor, his safety harness failed when he was working on the top of the Ferris wheel. Don was there one moment, and then gone. Sometimes people leave your life for no reason. I was 3 months pregnant with Callum. Fairy tale fucking over.
Oh boy, it's building up audio. It's like a Five Nights at Freddy's type thing. Whoa, 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 whoa. I know, you saw that, I know. There was a dude in here. There was totally a dude in here. Let's see if we can go super fast. Let's see if we can break it. Holy shit, building up speed. Boom, boom. Let's go watch it and see how fast it's actually going. Ho, ho, ho. That's pretty awesome. I don't even know where to go. Guess we'll continue on this way. I'm really not sure. Oh, that's, wait a minute, this is the way we came. Yeah, is this where we came? Yeah, I guess, yeah. It's pretty loud, actually. The cart fell off. The missing cart's right there. Whoa. Oop. Achievement unlocked. Spin, spin, sugar. Find the missing Ferris wheel cart. Really? I kind of like not knowing what the achievement list is. Just kind of playing it and a lot of the times, you know, I used to for a long time chase the achievement list and look at it and be like, I gotta know what it is and I gotta try for them. Now I'm just enjoying the games for what they are, which is definitely the way to do it.
A lot of people idolize their children. You hear them talking about their kids and just the way they talk, their fucking voices make me want to vomit. My angel likes to read, and little Johnny is so good on the piano. Fuck those people! You give up 9 months of your life carrying them. You traumatize yourself giving birth to them, and then you spend the rest of your life as their slave. Wiping asses, mopping up piss, feeding them. Little life-sucking monsters who take and take and take until... we all go insane. Any parent who pretends otherwise is just dishonest.
I have
That's
a dark feeling.
Choice supportive bias. I am honest. Callum really grinds my gears, and he owes me everything. Everything. It served the little fuck right if I just abandoned him.
Okay, this is getting a little dark here. I hope to God we didn't kill our kid. If we killed Callum, I'm going to be very unhappy. As a parent, this game has already got me freaked. If my kid was to get lost in an amusement park, especially a creepy old one like this, yeah, it'd be interesting. All right. I don't even think I want to ride on this thing. You know I have to, though, because that's how this game works. I like that little Family Guy reference they did, though. You know what grinds my gears? Check all these benches, make sure there's no notes or... Okay, that's a weird noise. Alright. We're going in. I
always wanted to ride this one. Never got around to do it before.
I have a bad feeling about this. Hey, but it's like Six Flags. No lines, no waiting. Okay, well... You guys ready for this? There we go. Oh, an achievement unlocked. Ups and downs, 50 points. Take a roller coaster ride.
What do you want?
We need to talk about Callum.
Uh-oh.
What do you mean? What have you done to him?
I? That's insulting. You and your boy are everything that this place doesn't want. The antithesis of what we stand for.
Where is Callum?
The poor child. He tried so hard to do what he was taught. He even left you a trail of breadcrumbs. But the park is just so hungry.
Oh god, he's on both sides of this.
Tell me where my son is.
The witch has him now. Has both of you. No happy ending here, I'm afraid.
Just leave me alone.
Fool. You always were.
Oh, no. Oh, here we go. What the hell? Holy... Kid, that was not cool. Holy sh! That was interesting. That was definitely interesting. All right. Oh, my stomach is in my nostrils. Just the sound and stuff in this game. Oh, we got a page. Alright, it works. The calculations and adjustments work. The transport and storage mechanisms seem to be flawless. What a wonderful day. If only these people knew what they were fueling. And so what if a few people leave the park at the end of the day, feeling down? So what if the children are more scared than excited to be on the roller coaster? This could be the doorway to immortality. And such doorways only open to those who have them and will try to find the key. Ugh. This game is fantastic, the way the atmosphere. That's why I like these kind of games, because I mean you can buy all the shooters, you can buy all the other games, which I love too. But there's just something about a game that lets you do this. You know, like a Telltale game, you gotta kind of follow. Yes! Flashlight! Haha. Wait a minute. I knew that was a flashlight before. 50 points. Hope's light. Obtain a flashlight. How do we turn it on?
Where are you?
How do we turn the thing on?
I can help you, Callum.
Can I take the axe? How do I turn the flashlight on? Okay, so we got a flashlight. I don't know how to turn it on. I don't know quite how to turn it on. It must be one of those automatically when you get their areas. You can turn it on type thing.
Callum has bruises on his arms, finger marks. Someone has been hurting him. I've asked him, demanded really, to know where he got the marks. But he doesn't want to answer me. Something has scared him into silence. He doesn't dare talk. He's been changing too. Something sinister lurks in the darkness behind his eyes. I catch him staring at me at odd moments. In the night, he tosses and turns and cries out words that I cannot understand. When I try to soothe him, he snaps and bites at my fingers. I think he wants to talk to me. I think he wants to tell me. They are watching him every minute of every day. They are whispering to him in his sleep, changing him. They are taking my baby away from me.
Let's try it this way.
There will be pain. But I love him, and in the end, he will understand why.
Not sure if we're supposed to go right or left there, or if there's a wrong or a right. The hell was that? What do we got here? Sideshow Alley. Okay. Oh, newspaper.
The whole town was shocked by
Cotton
that
Candy Corp saves South. Cotton Candy. Oop, hold on. I got an achievement here. 70. Wow. 75. Killer instinct. Cotton Candy Corp leaves sour taste in parkgoers' mouths. Yesterday evening, visitors of the Atlantic Island Park were shocked and horrified by the discovery of a dismembered corpse behind the cotton candy stand. According to the local authorities, the corpse had yet to be identified. However, they may have confirmed the remains appear to be those of a child. Oh, no. The corpse was discovered by a group of teenagers from the Innsmouth Academy who noticed a pair of ravens tugging at something just out of sight behind the shack. Nathaniel Winter, the owner of the Atlantic Island Park, has released the following statements. It is true tragedy when something like this occurs, especially in a place that was designed to bring forth happiness and joy. The staff of Atlantic Island Park offer their condolences to the family and friends of the victim and will cooperate fully with authorities to help them bring this case to rest. The Solomon Chronicle will provide daily updates on the story going forward. Oh. Please tell me this isn't Callum.
This isn't again, Callum!
I really hope it's not.
Don't let the witch put me in the oven!
What? Oh, boy. Okay. That's not creepy at all. Oh, boy. Alright, let's... I hear the music. I hear jingling. And I wish I could turn on my flashlight. I guess I don't technically need it. Let's check these benches, make sure there's nothing. Let's see if we can open any of these doors. Can cotton candy can't go behind there. Whack whack.
Callum? Okay. Callum!
Okay, there's blood. Oh god. Alright, let's go check it out.
Bastard. Who did this to him?
I can't get over there to get any of that stuff. Gotta search the body. Oh! Jesus Christ! Oh man. Oh my. Son of a bitch. That got me. That got me, y'all. That got me. Oh, that was good. That was so good. God, now the gate's closed. Guess we keep exploring. Oh, that just made my heart jump out of my chest. Whew. Oh my. And if I would have ran past it and went the other way, I may have missed that. So that. Whew. Alright. So how do we get out of here now? Alright. There's got to be something we're missing here. Can we go in? Alright. I guess maybe go check that dead body again. I really don't want to come over here again.
I'm not playing anymore, Callum!
Alright, so that's not it.
I'm scared!
You and me too, Callum. Okay. So there's got to be something I need to find to move on. Oh, it said saving. Okay. Where didn't I look?
Callum? Callum!
Alright, there's got to be something in here I didn't touch. Or didn't find.
What are you scared of?
I triggered something. Oh, there we go.
These are mine.
Oh, can I read what it says? 100 milligram tablet. I can't read what it is. She's on some kind of meds. Oh. Boy. What does that say? Is a fat pig, but his daughter is hot. Not safe. Your mother says no to graffiti. Some kids laugh, some kids cry, but mostly children simply die. Fear the boogeyman. Stop picking your nose then. Can't believe anything they tell you. Are you better off than you were 4 years ago? Reagan, 1980. Alright, okay. What the? Whoa! No. Do not want. No. Can I? Look at this thing. He doesn't want me to go that way. He just yelled at me, so. Oh. Look at eyeballs. It's messed up shit. Oh, okay. That was cool.
Don't touch me.
This is like the thing you spray in the water and it blows up. Is that the same newspaper I already read? Future Times by Laurel and Hottie. Belly button is the signature of your personal creator. I believe her name was Mama. Every 17 child is a magnet of sinfulness. Made omniscient, Omnisciplin? I don't know. Sorry, I butchered that. By broken fires and coastal strain, we don't believe that the earth belongs to the battered goats and shamrock afterbirth. Only the truly naked warns the righteous indignation are severed by war-cross cleavages and thrust exercise arrhythmia. Beaumont will come to the island bearing a talisman, and he will shatter the seals that blind the orthodoxy of corruption. Only then will priest shoot sleut reveal, housewives pronificate, and delayed messiahs make axles for the rescue of Tango and Cash. Excuse me. Ugh. Sweet the temptress who gripes the shaft, twists the shaft, absconds with the third age, tire into fourth age darkness, while gods lie writhing on the shattered face of the earth. Kale has sweetness and grace, but her days are numbered, and heavy-fisted highs break before frozen wills and celiographic actresses in pencil and paper pornography. The all-seeing eye will provide decade-long updates on the story going forward. I'm sorry, I tried to read this the best I can, guys. The writing is really, really small and off on this thing. And this is trippy. Kind of read that graffiti. Something carried away. What is this thing? Whoa! Pickled punks? What do we think? Do we leave? Do we leave all tripped out? Or we... You know what? I wonder if I go back to that dude if he's gonna tell me to leave. Yeah, he's not here anymore. Alright, let's get out of here. Oh, wow. Literally just chills. Chills. Oh god, she's cutting.
Oh god, no.
Trigger warning, folks. Oh shit. Oh shit. What about a feeling we're gonna end up in a mental institution or something? Oh, got an achievement. What strange trip it's been. Find the pills. At least we didn't end up in some kind of weird, like, afterthought. Excuse me. Alright. So.
The park is a collage of contradictions all of its own. Millions of people die every year in car crashes, and the park has little cars designed specifically to simulate that action. Here the children scream with joy. In the sideshow alley, you can walk away with 15 cents worth of mass-produced Chinese teddy bears, while a grinning carny pockets your hard-earned $5.
We're not going back into there.
Lie beneath the sullen waters of the lake. The tears of jilted lovers, the soiled condoms of illicit affairs, the clotted blood of the lonely suicide. And the face of the witch looms over it all. I always despised her toothy grin and warty nose. I hate that sparkle in her weathered, watchful eyes. I think Callum is waiting for me. Inside.
Okay. Well... Okay, what is this thing? I really want to know why.
This isn't a game, Callum!
I got a flashlight. Not quite sure.
Callum, where are you?
Follow the breadcrumbs.
I'm a little weary here. We have this flashlight, but I can't use it. None of the buttons seem to make the flashlight appear or not appear. Alright, well. Anything down here to come check out? This is the exit the way we came in? Okay, so we can't go that way. Make sure there's nothing down here. This is the way we came in, but we didn't. Oh, is that a note? No, it's not. Alright. Anything going on inside there? No. There's no notes on any of these tables or anything, right? Don't mind me, just looking on through. Skippity dip 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 doo dip doo. Yada yo. Alright, nothing here, nothing there. I don't want to go in here. This has got to be some kind of haunted house. Carrie killing is a Satan's whore. Oh yeah, this is where we were at the beginning. Now that we have a flashlight. Alright guys. Let's do it. Oh, that frame rate. Getting a loading screen. We must be going to a new area. We're at about an hour and 12 minutes right now, so we got to be getting close to the end here. So far, I've enjoyed what I played and definitely was worth my $12. I have no complaints. Will I play it again after? Maybe not, but or I probably will if I miss stuff. I don't know if we're going to get everything. And check the list. Oh, okay, we got a flashlight. Oh, God. I have a bad feeling about this.
Leave me alone.
Yeah, good, you can't shut it off and there's no battery. My skin is literally crawling. Oh, we got an achievement. House of Horrors, 100 points. Enter the House of Horrors. Boy, they did not get creative with these achievements. Oh. Oh, is that him? He's right there. Is that a cutout? Yeah, it's a cutout. Okay. Son of a... Oh, we got a page. Done. Atlantic Island Park closed its gates. A jeering through the townfolk gathering as we hung the heavy iron padlock to the gates. Small-minded foe, scared of what they don't understand. My machines are silent and dejected, but I am not beaten. I have sent my wife and son back to Boston, and I have rested... I have retreated here, to the House of Horrors. I must think. Oh, God. Okay, so... Okay, hold on. I'm gonna look around there. Make sure there's no... Nathaniel Winter, welcome to the Atlantic Park. Can read or grab or okay, well, what is up with my eyes? I look like a zombie. Okay, our eyes are normal over here. Check around. Whoa, son of a... Oh, you bastard. I should have been prepared better for that. Son of a bitch. That got me. It's kind of funny because, you know, it's an older park, these cutouts. If you were in the park in real life, that wouldn't have scared you, but... Oh, why? He disappeared. You know he's going to pop out on me again because I'm going to probably look in a mirror and something's going to come behind me. It's gonna come at me, isn't it? I don't trust you, you big bastard. I'm gonna walk this way. You just stay right where you are. I said stay. Can't go that way. Nothing on this table. I don't like the creaking. I thought that was underwear. Oh, son of a... Oh. Yes. Yes. I don't know what's up with these big German-looking World War II. Oh, my heart's beating like a million miles. Which one's gonna do it? One of these guys. Something's gonna happen here. Double-sided, too. Oh, there he is. I see it. The shadow. He's there. Is he down? Jump scares are plenty, apparently. Sound design is perfect. God. Alright. What are you gonna do to me? Do we go in this room? I say we go in this room. Something's gonna happen. Really? That's a missed opportunity. Nothing's gonna happen. Oh, that could have been cool if like the guy moved in the mirror. Yeah, I'll check out this room. Let's go check that other room. Just oh, I don't like the look of this. Seems like a lot of missed opportunity here. Ah, I knew that was gonna happen. Still jumped. I still jumped and I knew it was coming. Damn you. A door that way. Let's check this room out. Against my better judgment. Oh, see? Good thing I came in here. Incidents, and I cannot dismiss them as random chance. The park works, but something has interfering with its intended function. It's as though the very air in this place is corrupting the power. Even as I collect it. A few casualties here and there are acceptable, but when the employees go on stabbing rampages, it draws attention. You think? I'd rather not have boys in blue, either kind, investigating this place too closely. It's a shame about Steve. I rather liked him. So basically, everybody's going on murderous rampages. That's great. Oh, what? Man, this game is messing with all of my senses. Very well done. Alright, this guy's gonna light up. I know he is. He's gonna fall. Nothing? Really? Whoa! Alright. I was looking at the other guy, so... I guess we missed that one, because I didn't... go off and... that guy didn't scare me. Oh, I just heard a dog whine. Oh, do not want. Okay, what? Okay. Oh no. I guess we're chasing him that way. Alright, which one of you is gonna jump out at me? I'm gonna say something here. Something here. Alright. I'm literally on edge right now. I have no... Here we go. Oh, then the basement. It's always the basement. No. Oh, crap. Okay. Alright. This door is locked. They took my flashlight? Alright, we got a book. Nightmare Circus by Farron Calm. A circus burns to the ground on opening night, killing dozens. The owner is put to death by an enraged mob of town folks. Just as he shouts out a curse, now Raven, a dark-souled wanderer, comes to the ruins at dusk in search of his missing mother. Let the show begin. Okay. And we're in some kind of old tiny house.
After they let me out, they gave me Callum back and sent me home with a handful of breadcrumbs.
What?
A bit of sweet home. I barely recognized it. Where there had been color and light, there were shadows and regrets. Where there had been warmth, there was a bone-deep coldness that never went away. I tried my hardest to keep the ghosts at bay. Don, watching from the dusty corners while I tried to teach his son to read. My father, coldly assessing me and finding me lacking. I devoted myself to Callum and did the things that they told me. It will get better, they said. Every day will be a little better than the last. I'm in the woods now, lost and afraid. Things never got any better.
That's twisted. So it sounds like she was institutionalized and they gave her kid back. Unless I'm misinterpreting this. Alright, disconnect notice from the Dunwich Power Company. After multiple attempts to collect payment, we regret to inform you that your service has been disconnected or will be disconnected shortly. Please do the following. Make the payment listed as on your last bill. Contact us on 555-7868, and we can arrange a payment plan so that you can immediately be reconnected. If you believe that this is an error, call us on, there's a phone number, to discuss your options. If you are unable to make a payment, please contact your local welfare office to discuss a placement for you and your loved ones. Winter in Maine is cold and brutal. Don't face it without electricity, the Dunwich Power Company. Okay. I guess we're going to find out a little more what's going on here. Okay.
Leave me alone!
Looks like we got Caleb's hat. Okay, Okay. Ooh, we got a Rubik's Cube. I love you from Callum. I have a bad feeling about this. Alright, let's examine the wilting. Susan Anscombe. With this novel, Susan Anscombe cements her place as one of the most important science fiction writers of a generation. The wilting, a solar flare, has struck the Earth. Millions of people are uprooted from their homes. A young meteorologist searches desperately for a way to stop global overheating. Add an exotic dancer named Chance O'Hara and is the key to saving the world again. Dynamic, exciting, bombastic, everything we've come to expect. Alright. Let's see. Anything else here? You guys have the same feeling as me, as this lady's just nuts. And she killed her kid. And I will tell you, this game makes me want Condemned 3 with the Unreal 4 engine, huh? What about it? Anybody else? Any of you guys play Condemned? If you have, hit it up in the comments below if you'd want one too, because that's one I want. Alright, here's shopping list. Milk, cheese, bread, butter, corn, potatoes, apples, fish sticks. Remember, drop off Callum. Electricity bill, fix faucet. Wait a minute. Do I fix the faucet with this thing? Can I take the wrench? No, I guess I can't. Alright. Let's check out what's in the fridge. Please don't be Callum. Alright, we got legs. Here we go. You know, let's try the door. It's probably going to be locked anyway, but... Yep. Had to try it. Couldn't leave the place without trying it, you know? Alright, the boiler. Okay, here we go. Read the letter. Lorraine, I received a letter that I'm quite surprised. You ran off with your father all those years ago, then disappeared off the edge of the map, and when I finally track you down, refused to answer any of my letters. And now you write to me asking for my help. I have another family now and another life. Your father was a horrible man, and I regret years that I wasted with him. I love you. I loved you. I truly did. Every year you grew more and more like him. You were his girl, never really mine. Still, I would have fought for custody if you hadn't run away with him. It broke my heart, but needed to go on living. I can't let you back into my life without picking up old wounds. I'm sorry, Lorraine, but you just can't do it. Maybe one day it'll be easier, and I can meet Callum. But not yet. I am not ready to forgive you. Please don't contact me again. Karen. Oh, wait a minute. Okay. So, are we lesbian, and... I killed our son because I'm like my crazy dad who owns this park? I don't know if that's true, but if it is, that's a good twist. Miss Mallard, as we agreed in our meeting today, we considered full recovery from your illness. This letter is official notification that you were considered of sound mind and body may return to work at any time. Please note that you should discontinue any medications that you have been using and dispose of any remaining medicines. If you feel at any time you're suffering a relapse, then please contact your local physician immediately. We wish you continued good health, Dr. Spencer Dunwich Medical. Okay, so something happened, and we ended up in a psycho ward. Oh my god, did we kill him or have something to do with our son's death? Is our dad the owner of the park? So many questions I don't have answers to yet. Dunwich Emergency Services, here we go. This is about us, Lorraine Kelly. 1977, which is weird because it looks newer. Alright, notes from the overseeing psychiatrist. Lorraine seems to be suffering from depression that began early in her pregnancy. Oh no. I'm telling you guys. Our discussions have made it obvious that these episodes stem from grief of losing her partner, Don, who died about 6 months ago. There are several unresolved issues with her father. After being kept under careful observation, we provided standard treatment for this disorder, including electroconvulsion therapy. The patient responded and made a rapid recovery. Okay, so we don't get along with our dad, our husband died, and we had severe depression from being pregnant, which is like postpartum. Oh, here we go, let's read the notice. Oh, this is real tiny. I gotta squint in. It's from a law office. Miss Mallard. Our inquiry into the estate of Mr. Donald Williams has been completed. We regret to inform you that the primary beneficiaries of his estate, including a life insurance settlement for accidental death, were listed as Rose Williams and Richard Williams of New York State. The deceased parents... Our agency made contact with Mr. and Miss Williams and explained your situation, especially as regards to the birth of Donald's son, Callum. Oh, okay. Unfortunately, they were not receptive to our overtures, and they specified that without any legal proof that the biological relationship, they consider you ineligible to receive any of the monies from Donald's estate. They have asked that you no longer contact them regarding this matter. I understand that this may have a negative impact on your current financial situation, and I hope that I am not being too forward when I enclose a bill for our services for this letter. Okay, so they're denying their son died and they're and left her stuff, but his parents are keeping it. And she's going through depression. Oh, this is, we're going even deeper, man. Which is weird, because we're supposed to be in a haunted house, but now we're in a regular house. Alright. What the hell? Quack, quack, quack. Quack, quack, quack. Something don't come back. What? Here we go. Alright, what kind of book is this now? Is this the same book from before? Nightmare Circus? Yep. The park was waiting for a child to taken. Using joy for baiting, while the mother's mind is breaking. Oh, God, okay. Here we go, taking pills again. Okay, so she obviously, this is during her mental breakdown. Because we're replaying the same area we went to, but it's different. Lorraine, things aren't right between us at the moment, I know. I want to try and explain it. I think it's because I am so far from home, and I am working too hard every day, working at the park. I got a
spring inside my mind. Winding tight, it's getting worse, like a spring inside my mind, winding tighter, tighter, and tighter. When we go for drinks after work, it gets a little better. The guy's relaxing and we laugh and we're good people again. I don't want to come home to you without being in my right mind. But this is the job. But when this job is done, we need to get out of this place. You need to go back to the city where I don't feel like this anymore. I love you, Donald. P.S. I was thinking about names for boys and girls. I like Callum for a boy and Emma if it's a girl.
Okay, so... what do we got going on, okay? Here we go. Shocking Truth, Hunger, the Story of Voldemort. In the spring of 1933 in the Soviet Ukraine, an entire population found themselves without food. Over the course of the coming months, the situation grew critical, and the reports of mass malnutrition began to filter into the upper echelons of government. The people had been left with very little to bite or sup, and it was become one of the greatest tragedies of mass starvation in the world has ever seen. Now, our panel of Soviet experts have uncovered compelling evidence that the families were forced to resort to cannibalism in order to survive that terrible winter. In this never-before-seen expose, read about how starving parents cooked and ate their own children in order to survive. All here in the pages of the Shocking Truth story. Oh man, we had the gingerbread song going on. Oh, this is turning dark, people. This is turning dark. Oh, what? Shy. H-B-E-M. Oh. I love you from Callum. More meds again. And
of course she's going fucking nuts. The wilting. With this novel, Lorraine's... Oh, whoa, it changed our name. With this novel, Lorraine cements her place as one of the most important science fiction writers of a generation. The wilting. A solar flare struck the Earth. Millions of people are uprooted from their homes. Oh, we already read this. This one didn't change. This is still the same. Oh, wait, there's meds down there. You see those pills down there, guys? Under the bed? Oh, she's going deeper and deeper here. There's meds right... Oh. Here we go again. Milk, cheese, bread, butter, corn, potatoes, apples, fish sticks. Zoloft prescription. Remember, take the pills, follow up with Dr. Spencer, organize babysitter for Callum. I see Callum there. I don't want to go to him yet. I don't want to go to him yet. I guess we're going to have to go to him. Oh. Callum. All right, let's examine the wine here. What am I looking at here? There's a hole in it. I see that, but what am I supposed to do with it?
Please, don't make me see.
I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do with the wine there. Hopefully nothing. Kind of has that. Oh, there's that song again. It's a pogo ball. Check that shit out. I have a bad feeling we drowned our kid or something. We killed him in some way. This is like the PT demo that they had on PlayStation. Thank you, William, for the new watch. It is very nice. It has made me happy. Carrot. Read note. Oh, God, this is little. Our inquiry into... Or is this the same one? Yeah, this is... The same one, except there's like splatters on it now. Alright. Here we go again. This is totally like the PT demo. Okay, let's see what else is going on. Did they change the book again? Nightmare Circus. A chipmunk goes to stab, stab, stabbing, and the eyes a jab, jab, jabbing, and all the townies gab, gab, gabbing. Just lie down and let it happen. Basil Gengelaween. That's kind of disturbing in many levels. Look at all the pills. Oh, God. We can't see ourselves, but... There we go, we got a render. Oh, it's burnt, I can't see. When we go for drinks after work... Oh, okay. This is the one we read before. With the name, now it's like ripped. We're going deeper and deeper into her madness. This is fantastic. A long time ago, in the forest and the woods, lived a woodcutter, his wife, and his two children, a boy named Hansel and a girl named Gretel. They were very poor and had very little to bite or sup. The story has been doctored to hide the truth from unsuspecting public. Now our panel of fairy tale experts have uncovered compelling evidence that Hansel and Gretel were in fact eaten alive. In this never-before-seen expose, read about how their parents inexpertently tried to cover it up by telling stories about a witch and a house made of candy. All here in the pages of the shocking fake story. Okay, so...
Oh, the hat's gone. It's on the floor now. Oh, it's bloody. We killed Callum. Oh, man. Oh, we totally killed him. This is... Oh, I hear the music. Oh, all the meds are gone. Remember there was meds in the drawer? Now there's two meds on the counter. Look at the meds everywhere. All right, let's see if this book changed the wilting. No, it's still the same. 606. I can hear him talking in the radio. We killed our kid. Remember, more pills, ticket to Atlantic Island Park. Okay, so we need more pills and she wants to go to the park. Why does she want to go to the park? Look at all the pills everywhere. She's totally going nuts. She's totally going nuts. And the wine is gone. Oh my god, we totally killed him. There's blood all over the floor now. More pills. What's gonna happen in here now? History of Solomon Island. History of Solomon Island. I didn't run away. Dad took me. What? Oh my god. She went nuts because her kid went missing, I think. Oh, there's blood there. This would make more of sense that she went nuts and her kid was nuts. Thank you, William, the new one. We already saw that. Because if her husband died, he was working there. Is that her husband? If her husband died and took him back, took their son, that means her son's dead. Which means we probably went nuts and killed him because we were being possessed. I don't know. I'm trying not to... Oh, what? What? Oh, I don't like this. The boogeyman goes walk, walk, walking, sneak, stealing, a stalk, stalk, stalking. He is really a talk, talk, talking. Now he's not balk, balk, balking. Cerebral cortex win. Oh, good. I don't like this at all. Okay. More pills. Deeper inner madness. This one's missing his eyeballs, for Christ's sakes. Look at the picture. Blood everywhere. You notice the kid's always with a demon now? The mom and him are demons on the picture. Alright, what's... The woodcutter is dead, the witch always wins. 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 The witch always wins. All here in the pages of this broken story. Oh, good lordy lord. Oh, what? Now we got dolls in the bed. Now there's a blood inside the hat. It says, does it say he dies? Can't turn it. See her cry, see her die. Ache her lie. see her try. Look at all the pills everywhere. That must be my husband Donald and me. My two best friends, Don and Laura. Can you hear us, Lorraine? One of the most important, a sun will struck the earth, millions of cattle are uprooted from their homes, a young shadow searches desperately for a way to stop the global domination, an exotic dancer, listen, Lorraine, is trying, is the key to saving the world again. Irresponsible, answer us, Lorraine. Lorraine, we are watching. Oh, wow, this is just going deeper and deeper. I missed those little subtle clues the first. Oh. Fucking miss. Alright. Zoloft prescription. Remember, you are alone. Nobody loves you. Callum is no longer who he once was. Oh. Told you, we're going nuts and we're gonna kill. We killed our son. There's no way around it. Pills in the sink now. Oh no. Oh no. That's what the Hansel and Gretel story's about. We stabbed him in the head and put him in the goddamn oven. Oh. God, that's what the Hansel and Gretel story and the ride was all about. That has to be what happened. Oh my God.
Give it to me!
What is going on?
I'm a horrible mother. Where is he?
Oh, God. Oh, man, this is... I need to know what happened. I need to know. As we agreed in our meeting today, we considered you... to be batshit fucking insane. Let's be clear, you are no way sound mind and body, and you're a danger to everybody around you. Please note that your only escape should be drugs. A shitload of them. Smoking, snorting, and intravenous. Take them any way you want. Take as and as often as you can. That shit can only make your life better. In case there was any doubt, you are suffering a relapse and nobody really cares. Nobody can help you. Don't fuck this up, Dr. Spock. We are officially batshit crazy. I didn't run away, Dad took me. We're officially mentally fucked. Oh. Thank you for the new watch. Oh, he crossed out the man now. Look, there's three of them on the picture now. And then the eye that's looking at him. Oh my God. Lights knocked over and flickering.
Let's see what clever kind of rhyme they got on here now. Lorraine, Lorraine, I need you to focus on what we are discussing. The chipmunk killer, Steve Gardner. He is locked away for what we did for those, what he did to those kids. Nathaniel Winter hasn't been seen in years, but he is nowhere near Atlantic Island Park. We've established this. You know this. And the music is ramping up. She's gonna have a full mental fucking break. The woodcutter is dead. The witch always wins. The woodcutter is dead. The witch always wins. The woodcutter is dead. The witch always wins. Oh, god damn it. We killed him in his bed. Oh, the blood's running down the walls. See her lie. See her try. See her cry. See him die. Say bye-bye. Ask her why. Oh, man. Oh. Look at the blood running down the walls. Don and Laura. The wilting. We are talking. Can you hear us, Lorraine? The killing. A son will be devoured. All the cattle will be enslaved. The shadow lies on your future. Our domination. If you are listening, Lorraine, you are the key to the damning world. We are irresponsible. You can join us, Lorraine. Lorraine, we are one. In the picture, there's three. She is going deeper and deeper. Oh, no! Oh, no. Forget Don, Dad. Okay, not him. Is that supposed to be me? It is me. Is that my girlfriend that wrote? And is that Dawn? That's Don, because he's in the picture with the same shirt. And that's definitely me. Who the hell's that? I think that is my girlfriend. And the baby's roasting in the frickin' oven, like I said. Oh, I knew it. I totally knew it. Oh, man. Oh, God. Oh, we're dead. We're dead. Oh man, oh man, oh man. I didn't run away, Daddy took me. The owner of the park is the father, not Don isn't actually the father. Is that what I'm supposed to get out of that? Daddy took me. You will watch me. Oh no, we have to. Oh, don't make me watch him die. Don't make me do. No, don't make me. Don't make me. Please don't make me. Whoa, what's different? It's different.
Stories are told again and again, and from their shape we build our understanding of the world. Two children are led into the woods. They are lost for a time, but then are captured by an old witch. A child goes missing in Atlantic Island Park. He wanders lost for a time before finding his way into the mouth of an old witch. In the oldest version of this story, the mother and the witch were the same person.
I told you.
I never wanted to be the witch.
But I knew it.
Aren't I?
We killed him. Holy shit. My heart is like in my chest, like in my throat, I mean. That music, fire. Kids broke in today. It has been long since I heard laughter, so very long. I took one of them. I couldn't help myself. It was first, the others didn't notice. I liked hearing him laugh, this boy from the academy. I put him on a slab. I tickled him until he couldn't breathe. My machines came to life, whirring in time and gasp and shriek. I think this is delightful. The change wrought me in the machines is not yet complete. There must be other children I can lay inside my slab. Very BioShock feeling. This is, I don't want to know. This is his bedroom. Or the child's bed, at least. There's a book. Eyes Without Sparkle. Hansel and Gretel. What the fudge?
Callum? Callum?
Don't do it.
Callum!
Oh no. He's got a Cthulhu on his chest. I just noticed that. Oh no. 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 Fight it. No. No, 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 no. No! What did we do? What? What? Wow. Wow.
Hey, Lorraine. Lorraine. Don't blame yourself, Lorraine. People lose things all the time. Take a deep breath and think about the last place you saw your son.
In my heart and mind, I always return to Atlantic Island Park.
Oh, dreamlike state, 100 points. How did we do achievement-wise? Oh, I got all of them. Yeah, we got 1,000 out of that. All right. That was an amazing experience. Thank you guys for watching. I'm Gaming with Red. If you're new to my channel, I appreciate you giving a like and thumbs up. And if you liked what you saw here, please hit that subscribe button. And I put out videos at least once a week, usually between Monday and Wednesday. I will be getting on a set schedule. And wow, I can't believe it. That was an amazing, 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 amazing game. The ending was a little off, though. Like, did we kill him? I don't understand. I don't. It seemed like we went crazy, and that's kind of what happened. But we're dead. We were dead, hanging from the ceiling. I don't know if they were trying to throw it with a psycho. You guys have a better understanding, or you think you know what it is? Type it down in the comments below, because I'd love to see what you thought of it. I think we lost our son, and we went nuts, and he was taken. I don't know. They pretty much left it up to three different things in that story, and wow, wow. Thanks for watching, guys. I do appreciate it.